Welcome back to another episode of BioShock Infinite. We continue to try to do this.
Mechanism unlocks certain activities when Fink gives his blessing.
So what? We're stuck waiting for the cuckoo to go off?
No, there's a slot for some kind of key for manual winding. I've just gotta find that.
Sure seems like a lot of work to lock down a few doors.
Yeah, well, if there's one thing Fink loves, it's a lot of work.
I mean, yeah, I'm gonna have to go through all the doors, it seems. Or at least that'll be my guess.
Our current state of...
We've got the clock key.
Our current state of being, or lack thereof, has left my brother... unfulfilled. The biological urge to leave one's mark is strong. And it is not an impossibility. We could instantiate ourselves back in Columbia. Return to an old life for the possibility of creating new. But we died in that world. Returning would mean giving up part of us. Ourselves. We'd become flesh, and all that it is heir to. The mysteries of the universe would become once again... mysteries.
I know I have to go that way. I'm gonna go every way.
his plasmids? If there is a god, and I've seen more evidence to the contrary than in support, you'd think he'd have put Adam into the belly of a nice little seagull or crow. The cost of all these underwater expeditions are murdering my margins.
As to the matter of religion, let me place myself in the camp of the agnostic. I pretend to understand the mysteries of the infinite no more than you, Comstock, or anyone else for that matter. For the sake of argument, let's say this is all one unhappy accident, and we are all alone in our toils. Then who would Comstock use to control and shame us with rules that apply only to those with not a penny in their pocket? If there were no God, you could rest assured the first deed done by the first rich man would be inventing him.
Whose lock of hair is it?
Listen, I got you your gun. I'm here for my ass.
But my book of the wind died for the Vox Populi. You either an imposter or
I was gonna say she's supposed to pass out.
me a millionaire to clean this mess up.
Not the brightest of guys. Looks like this might come out down below there. Be a good thing. She was like quieter when she got into these things. Jeez.
Who did this?
Yeah, I'll come out right behind this person.
I'll hunt you down.
Ooh. That was a toughie. Sorry, I'm looking for a hair sample.
Set me up to kill her.
Yeah, she did.
To turn me into what?
A killer.
Yeah, well, mission accomplished. I'm no martyr. How did you do it, Booker? How did you?
Elizabeth, I'm not Booker.
And neither am I.
I haven't done one of these. It just disables it. Songbird and Big Daddy, both based off of humans.
It all makes a kind of sense. The little sisters and the big daddies. Songbird and me.
Constants and variables.
Imprinting. That's a wire mother. If you separate a gorilla from its real mother, it will imprint on almost anything. Even that.
Why would Fink care about that?
Songbird. He wanted him to imprint on me.
Well, if I recall, that was a problem he solved.
Stuff. Slab.
What's that?
It's a skeletal formula for oxytocin. That's the chemical that bonds mothers to children, women to men, and
songbirds to little girls.
Apparently not. Fink dismissed it as an unsuitable vector. These poor things. Fink couldn't get them to imprint, so he left them to die.
I'm just waiting for something to happen.
Imprinting failed. That can't be right. Clearly they formed a connection between Songbird and me.
How?
I was so young, I always remember him just being there. Be a prototype or something.
Is it a human?
Does it matter?
Creepy.
Huh?
Oh boy.
Booker, the little girl in the film. It's me. My God. I remember. He'd crashed into the tower. I guess he was in some sort of fight. I waited there thinking, I don't know, that something would happen, but he just lay there, moaning. I couldn't just...
The lion with the thorn in its paw. So much for science.
I should have just left him there to die. Should have just... I will never escape it. Exploited, exploiting me, Comstock, you, Sally. It's like a wheel of blood spinning round and round.
Subject's personal effects. Yeah, it is my hair.
This must be the genetic sample Su Chong wanted.
He sent you all the way back here for a sample of your own hair.
He doesn't know I was once the child that imprinted on Songbird. But to him, all the answers lie in DNA. Men like Su Chong mistake an ounce of empathy for a pound of science.
A lot of them. Come on, walk this way, please. Alright, well, we're gonna call this episode here. When we come back next time, we'll try to get to that tear. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please leave a like. Bye.